Hello everyone, welcome to Athral Studio. I'm so excited to see you after a long time. I hope you are getting my audio and video nicely. So please type a yes if in case it's all going through well. Yes, welcome everybody. Welcome everybody. I could go through the chats and I could see somebody's attending it for the first time. You're most welcome. Okay, so can I get a yes if in case my video and audio is going through well? Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you. I got a yes, and therefore I would be starting. So starting with our course now, first of all, I couldn't reach you for a long time. So I'm so sorry about it. I was traveling and was not available. So but now coming back, we will all resume to our own schedules of every weekend we will be doing our live sessions and one after the other going through all the forecasts of India and other forms as well. So now this what we are going to start today is the FUD art. Now when we say FUD paintings, some say PUD, some say PUD, some say it FUD. So there are different accents where they call, but the painting stays the same. So here I would be saying it PUD. It's a FUD painting. Now in FUD paintings are the scroll paintings that are very old. They are 700 years old and they are religious scroll paintings. We do see few of the gods in those paintings, but majorly these paintings are done for the deities, the local deities that were the Babuji and the local deities of those places. Okay, this is from the Rajasthan. So this is a small introduction to our painting, what we are going to do today. It's a Rajasthani painting and this is majorly done on the cloth. The cloth is cotton cloth, canvas or khadi, those kind of cloth is used, and they are prepared as a canvas where the wheat paste is mixed with the gum that is extracted from the plants, and then they do a one coat of it to make it a give good binding and a smooth finish to the cloth. Oh, thank you for all the messages. Even I missed it a lot, but then I was too much with my family, festivities and functions. So I couldn't do any of the lives. I'm so sorry about it. So, okay. Now, I will be placing my video on the table. And you can see this. What I have taken is an A4 size paper. So this is a normal printing paper size. The paper I have taken is a little thick. So little thick, if you are using paints and watercolors, then you will be using a little thick paper. Otherwise, if you are doing a rough drawing of what we are doing today, then you can go for a normal printing paper also, if it's going to be a rough drawing for you. For me, I have taken a paper which is a 240 GSM. So GSM, as in, like I repeat all the time, GSM is grams per square meter, and this is what it tells how much the paper weighs. So how heavy the paper is, and depending on how heavy the paper is, we can opt for the paints and the water. For thin ones, you can go for a dry medium, but here. Now, the things that we would be using throughout the our FUD paintings is, obviously we will be doing it on the paper and not on the canvas or cloth. You can learn it here, and then if you want, you can do it on the cloth using acrylic paints. Now this normal pencil, you can go for any pencil, eraser for any corrections if you want to make, scale is used for doing the borders, and a waterproof pen. This is the basic thing for the drawing part. Now for the coloring, you can use your brush pens. That if I show you, the brush pens can also be used if you are doing it on the paper. So these are the Camel brush pens that I would be using sometimes. Otherwise, I can also go for poster colors or acrylic paints, depending on what you want to take. So this is all. Anybody has any doubts on the material, please write it out. So I will answer it all. Ma'am, please tell my name. Tharu Nika. Okay, yeah. Name calls, huh? Okay. So my Diwali, how was my Diwali? And it was very good. It was fabulous. I celebrated it with my family. So that's the reason I was not here. I'm so happy about it. A3 size book. Okay, great. Now this work, this workshop, which will extend for about 5 to 6 days, and it's going to be taken only on the weekends. What we will be doing is, there is no prior experience required. Only the little, also the little ones can join. So normal pencil is okay. You can go for a mechanical pencil. You can go for a normal pencil, whatever suits you. You can take just a pencil is okay. Now, what palette do we use for the FUD paintings is basically, so if I know that few people do the jottings of the notes, if in case you want to know what palette we use, what color sequence we use for these paintings, they are all bright colors. There is no perspective at the bottom. So I will be starting with the painting, and thereafter I will be talking about all these details also. Giving it a border. Generally, when we do the pod painting, we see that there is a flat border. And here I'm doing using a scale. Please use a scale for precision. See to it that your border stays even on all the sides. So I've given it a boundary. Now here, after this, I will give a very thin line, which is a pipeline, I would say. It's just like a very thin line, which generally the borders are kept plain and flat color with no design. Only a few places you will see some line work, and otherwise it will be bright in color. Majorly the outer border, the outside border stays red. That is a very bright red. That is the, this portion stays red. Now I will be doing a double border. Even if it is a double border, it doesn't give you much of the design or intricate patterns. It's very plain. It's very simple. But it has a very distinctive style. You can make out the paintings, the features and the figures are made very simple, and they have their own flavor to it. And here again, I'm doing a small pipeline, a small thin line, which is a thin border. So I will be doing the border in red and green. So the color palette that is used here in this painting is very bright. The color will be restricted to bright orange, red, yellow, black, blue, green and brown. That is the only palette. So basic colors, if you have in acrylic or in poster colors, you are good to go to make and color a painting. Yes, so I'm back now. Yes, and I have started all my lives as well as the private classes. So those who want, who I have few inquiries, people inquire about the private classes. I do take private classes for the kids also and for the adults. So you can message me directly on my Facebook page. So this is a basic structure that I made for the thing. Now, how do they start with the picture? Now here what I am doing is on the paper. Otherwise it is done on the khadi cotton or cotton. Khadi cotton and different fabrics. And the colors are obtained from stones and minerals. So in Rajasthan there is a lot of stone and very precious and bright color stones. These colors were extracted from them because it is a 700 year old art. So those times, these synthetic colors were not available to us. So that is when these organic colors from earth were obtained. They were powdered and they were mixed with the glue. And the glue was also not synthetic glue that we get these days. It was organic glue, and we used to get it from the plants like babool gum or different gum saps of the plants. We used to extract and soak it, filter it and mix it with the minerals and the stone powders, and then the color was ready. The brushes that were used for this was the mongoose hair brush. So mongoose has very fine hair. They were tied on a stick and to make on a desired thickness, and then it was made. Now what are we doing today is how to make a setting of a painting. So for the setting of a painting, generally the legendary stories of Babuji were narrated, and Babuji is a local deity of the place, and so we will go on to the topics of those as well, but we will just go on to the setting first. Generally, the court scenes are also made, since the life of Babuji is depicted in this. Here, I am doing the setting where we will see a court scene here in the half, and half will be open, so that you get the idea of all the elements that are done. The measurements for the paper is A5, and I have not kept any measurement for the border. If you want to see the measurement, it is 1 point something. I just did it randomly. So one is a slightly bigger border, so my one finger size width, and the other was a half of it, so that much. I didn't measure it. So here, now in these paintings we have different kinds of pictures where you will be seeing that there are compartments. They can be one painting at a stretch, and they can be compartments also. Now here I am doing it as in a little compartment also, so that you can get the idea of what is the feel of a compartment and what is the oversight of the compartment. So in Rajasthan we have a lot of palaces, and these compartments are one of those palace formations. I am making a compartment here. You don't have to be very specific about the size of the compartment. Okay, it can be a small box or a big box. Depending on how many elements you want to make inside, you can make the box. So here I'm just making a jharokha kind of a thing, where this is a palace jharokha. It can have different sorts of roof. So here I'm making a only curved roof like this. So it is very simple like this. Here we can go ahead and make some detailing of the design on the top. These are done freehand and no tracing or anything is involved. Here. Very simple drawings like this. And all of it goes up. So this is the top dome part of the building or the court that is there. And generally who is placed in the compartments is the ladies or the Babuji himself. So I'm making a small jharokha. Jharokha is done with curves here. I'm just taking the center roughly and making this kind of a shape. So do not trace, or just go freehand with a very liberal look to this place, and making some pillars in here. This gets to be a compartment where we can place a figure. Giving it a double line. Now too much of detailing is not required in these kind of paintings, and we can have one or two people. Now, when we make the people, it is the upside of the paper is not visible. There is only the border here. I'll just lift it up a little up so that you can see. I hope it is visible now. Okay. Now this. Here, after coloring, we will do a little bit of detail work. This is one setting that is there. Now, it also depends on how big the compartment is. It depends on the hierarchy of the place. And if the compartment or the charoka is big, somebody important is there. So, the figures are almost the same, but the hierarchy counts. So, if in a very big painting, we have a very big compartment where some male is sitting, considering that that person is the most important in that painting. So maybe the lords or the gods or the Babuji himself or any local deities who they sing. So now when these scroll paintings were done, after that they were displayed and the people used to sing along and narrate the story what they have depicted. So it was like a comic kind of a illustration. You will see small compartments like we do in the comic. Now here I will be doing a figure, a lady figure who's sitting. We'll come back to this a little later. Now if we do some festive scene, how to get onto the setting is festival or celebration. We can do the valance of the leaf, that's a mango leaf. We draw a long leaf here and then just like this, just change one side, and then that is the compartment of it, the midrib. It is kind of twisted. That's how we make it as. These paintings are done very freely. Okay, so free hand drawing is involved in these. When we are doing any religious festival, we do such kind of leaf pattern. If we do any celebrations where it's not, then we can also do the same thing as these colorful triangles or the bandana that is there. So this is a bandana that is for the religious scenes, and this is for the festival or celebration or street play or anything like that. So you can have this variation if you want to do some scenes where dandiya is being done or a street function or anything like that sort, you can do that as well. So here is the picture where I'm doing the mango leaf valance. If you have not subscribed the channel, please do subscribe and support it. We will be coming forward with many of the videos and workshops. So this is one thing. Now the setting. How do we come to the leaves and the flowers and other things that are there in the picture? So now when we come to the picture, it's not very important that everything will be indoors. There are few outdoors as well. And when we come to the outdoors, the perspective is not much in the picture. You will not see a lot of buildings or any other than the main focus of the picture. Now here I'm doing some bushes along here, as that will help you to know more about the how to make the plants. They are very simple. Just the trunk, desirable thickness, can be taken. Now this is it's not important to have it full. It can be half. It's just like a fountain here right now. Give the thickness of the leaf. Looks more like a flower right now. We get it like this. The center part gets as a shoot that is growing. This over here. Thank you, Deepa. Okay, and here like this. We make the midrib of the leaf. Later, these lines will come as the fall and they will show the direction where the leaf is bending. So this is how the leaf is, the plant. This in now this is a big plant. There can be different kind of trees. We will talk about different kind of trees, and we will be doing different kind of trees in each of our our sessions, so that we are not confined to just making of one type of the plant. So this is one here. How do we make bushes? Is we just make a big curve. These are very simple, highly simple paintings. Highly simple, and anybody can do. So basically just the drawing part will let you know, okay, these are the flowers and these are some of the leaves that are sticking out. Now the leaves are the same as we did it on the big one. It's just that they are a little small. The main attraction of a fart painting is the colors of it, and they are very brightly colored and contrast very well with the white background. Mostly we see that the background is white. If not bright a white, then sometimes it is the earth color. Earth color, if I say, it is wheatish color. That is the color that is on the background. Sometimes you will also see the gatha of it written. Gatha in the sense what has been said and sung. They write the verses of it. Sometimes the Ramayana has been depicted and they write the verses of that also. Some shlokas, some verses, that is also seen. But in the normal context, if it is not a relative drawing, then it is done in a very normal manner. Then we do not have those verses written. This. So this is one which bush is down over here. Now I hope this pencil drawing gets clear to you on the visuals. We have more plant also, which we will talk in the next one. The background of it stays white. So here we can have more valances and more flowers. Now, coming to the figure, I will lower down my camera so that you get a good view of how to make the figure. Now, this compartment, I'm doing a figure. The figure will be a figure of a lady. How do we draw that? I will show it to you in a rough paper first, so that it's easy for you to know how to form the picture. Now, the what feature is very important in this is, I'll just remove it and I'll show it to you on this paper first. The face is very circular. The face is very circular. Now, this is a very rough diagram of a circle, and how we go about on the face, I will be telling you. The proportions, how the body have to, we have to do the proportion is, the head size, we divide, if the sitting posture is there, we divide it into three equal parts. So if the head is like this much, the torso will be this, and the sitting posture will be this. So the whole figure will finish off in this three compartments. That is the proportion of the picture. But so this is what I'm drawing right now is just for you to understand while I will be switching on to my final picture. So here, this is the face, and here comes the torso. The torso is like this. The torso is the upper part. The hand is always, if folded, it is like this here. So this is the torso part, and this gets to be the sitting posture. So this is the sitting posture here. Okay, so I am just telling you this because the proportion wise you will get right if you divide it into three equal parts. Here also the hand will come. I will give you the distinctive how to make the hand and everything. Okay, so this is a very important element how to differentiate. So three equal parts. Now I'm coming to my picture here, and if in case you want to draw this lady, we will be drawing it into three equal parts. So 1, 2, and 3. So this division will let me know how big, and I will not fall short on the less space for the legs, or the torso will go short. So please consider that. Now this is a circle, and here will be the head. Here is the place where the torso will come, and this is the place where the leg is going to come. Now I will be going directly with the pen so that it's more visible to you. Now when we do the face, we will go along the line of the curve. The nose is straight here and curved at the bottom. Lips are like the three, like we make the number three. Then there is a chin followed by the same. So I'm following the same circle that is there. So this is one feature. Now the back side, this is a band. This is the borla, or it's a decorative piece that is done for the picture here. Now the eye, generally when we make the eye, the upper eyelid is quite straight, whereas the lower one takes a deep curve. This is how the picture is done. Now leaving a white spot in the eye for the shine, and then the eyebrow. This is a tikka, and this is the earring. So we do not do much of the details in the earring. The pictures are very, very simple. So this, the neck is not very thin. It goes and turns to the torso like this. This is the neck. And here is the dress. This part. Coming to the hair, here we will, starting from the eye to the earring, we will be making the ear. This is the ear part. The cover, generally in Rajasthan, ladies cover their head and they have a dupatta, or the shawl, whatever you could call it. It's a dupatta, it's a sari where they put it on the head. Now this here, I'm making the hand. Like this, bangles. And the hand has a very, they are not very well defined, and there is only one like this. Just a fist over here is made with three lines, and that shows the closed hand. The tassels, generally these bangles and the garlands and all the decorations are tied up, and they do not have links. The other side of the hand now. Again the bangle. Now this time again this thing goes this way, the same way. Now looking at the other side, it is the palm, and now we have a thumb here followed by the three fingers. This is how the hand is made. We can have a flower here. Like this. Sitting posture. Like this. Here are the borders. So this is the folded leg, and this is one leg that is upright. Now the dupatta comes down here with one fall over the shoulder. The other side of the dupatta is also shown like this. So this is the picture that is done in the fud style. Now what are the more decorations? When we'll come back to this. The blouses are short like this. So this finishes with this. Now ornamentation, the nose pin is very common and it goes outside on the other side. It is not over the face, on the face. And these are the tassels that are for the tying of the jewelry. So this is a picture. Now we will start. Anybody has any doubts, please, you can write it up here, because I am now reading all of them. If in case you have any doubts, you please ask. Okay. So the colors, as I said, yes, those who have not subscribed will not, I don't think they will be able to type in the message. So if in case you have not and you really have a question, please subscribe and then you can converse with me. Okay, no questions. Then we'll go ahead. Ma'am, we have to draw it with a pen. I drew it with a pen so that it is more visible to you. If you're not very comfortable, you can draw it with the pencil also. And later you can do that with a pen. Now here, I just did it for the clarity of it because the picture was relatively small. Okay, so it is more visible right now. So basic drawing is done over here, but I have not done any of the detailings. The detailings will come later. So what colors do we actually use for the picture? I will just zoom out a little so that you are able to see the picture here. And I am taking my poster colors or the swatches that are there. You can also use your brush pens for the same. Okay. So what I am using is the Doms, this color palette that I have. I have a lot many shades in here. Here, this, and it's right quite used up right now. Now what pen, if in case you are using a pen, I would remind you that please use a waterproof pen, because if you are doing the lines, then it will get disturbed. Here we will use different colors. Krishna or Pattachitra workshop, please show coloring also, ma'am. Sure, I'll upload it. As I was not available here, I was not in the place, so I was not in Bangalore, so I was not here, so that's why I couldn't. Now I'm back and I would do all the painting work as well. Okay, so now when we color this whole thing, the background of the picture stays white. We will start, even if you have drawn in pencil, it is okay. We will just start with the color. So the color we have to restrict to the coloring, and that is bright red, which is the border, green, blue, brown, black, bright orange, and yellow. Those are the major colors that are used. We do not use shades of pinks and purples and other shades. So this is a very limited color palette that we use in this picture. Now, I will just take some color. So just a bright yellow color. It's a chrome yellow or a lemon yellow, that is okay. What I am using here is a synthetic brush, round. and we just do the outlines of this. I mean, like just this mid portion. Once our color dries, then the detailing will be done directly with the, you can also use it a thin brush or a pen. If you are using cloth, then definitely you will have to use the brush and the paint and not the pen, until and unless you are using acrylic pens. We also get acrylic pens. No, it's not the golden color, it's the yellow color. Yellow. It's the yellow chrome. So you do get metallic shades, but please avoid doing metallic shades. It's not metallic shade here. Now, taking in green. And filling it across with green. You can take a darker shade of green also, but do not mix the color. So as in, like when I say do not mix the color, it means that do not shade this portion. Whatever color you take, you have to go through and through with that color. So it is a solid filling, solid color, flat color filling. So these pictures are very beautiful because of the contrast that it gives. And very easy, so all ages can do that. Tell me the shade of this color. It's light green. Generally, brighter colors are only used, so avoid using a sap green or a dull green, olive green. Take the brighter colors. So any mix of colors will, like teal blue or any other shade of blue, please don't avoid taking it. Avoid taking it, don't use those colors. I'm going very liberal and just applying it because all the details will come in later. This, what I could do more for the color is, I'll change my shade to a little darker green here. When you are doing any of the paintings, I advise you to do the outlines of the portions that you have to secure and not paint, and then you can just fill up the color. This way you will get, and I'm just rubbing my brush all over the white area. You will see a lot of lines as well, but now once this is all done, I'll just take a little bit of more and give it a even coloring now. This way you'll have, you can minimize your lines that will appear. So again, going quick on these portions. No, it's not acrylic. These are the paint swatches. Swatches, isn't it? Say, these are the cake, the poster color cakes that we get. It's not acrylic, but you can always do it in acrylic. I prefer doing poster colors in this because they are very opaque. They give a very bright color also. They are opaque and they do not have that gloss. If in case you are doing it on the cloth, then do it with acrylic. Else, try doing it with poster colors. Now this here. For all the greenery here, we will be doing it. Only one side I'm doing it green. The portions on the other side will I'll be taking a lighter green color or the yellow. You can also take yellow for that. See to it that your color doesn't mix. So otherwise it'll look like a shade. Here I'm giving it a shade, but then the shade is actually the light and dark, and it will be marked with the compartment. So there will be a line that will come in the middle, and it's not like blending. Do not blend the shade, just color two compartments separately. Like this. This portion is done. When we do the quartz, then this is mostly bright red in color. Now here, if I use this, I will also show it to you with the acrylic paint as well. So you can do it with acrylic also. You can also use a brush pen. So if in case, here is the brush pen set, and I have a lot many colors. I'll see the red. I'll just take the red and I'll show you how the brush pens it. That is also equally good. When you use the brush pens, you will get the effect of watercolor. So here, I'll show you all different shades here. Here, how it will happen. So this is more like a watercolor, more transparent here. When you will use a color which is poster color, I'll just show you that as well. So when I do it side by side, you'll get the idea of how it will be. Now, once you check it on your own, it will be easy for you to know what you want to opt for. See how beautiful this comes and how opaque. And this gets more quick as well. So I'm just filling a flat color of red. When the details will be done, then the finishing will come. Just filling in flat, rubbing it wherever there is accumulation of color. Just rub it off so that you get even tone of color. So this is bright red. Now coming to the yellow. We also see brown here, and I'll be showing you brown and yellow combination. Just blankly color the swatches, the areas. Just pick it from the swatch and fill it up. I'm taking the yellow. Generally, all the things that glitter and are done in like ornaments and all, they will be blankly done in yellow color. What's the size of the brush? Okay, what I have picked actually is a free brush that comes with the dome, but if I tell you, it will be around 6 round synthetic brush size, 6 in round. So few of them they do would not have the numbers, especially the ones that come free with the set that you that I showed it to you. So I'm just filling those compartments without any shades, no shading at all. Even this portion will be left white with inside the court room. Now coming to the leaf here, I'll take a little darker red, brighter one. Bright orange and red are the two shades that we use for this. So this is very bright red. And I'm coloring all the flowers that are here. Now, for the dress, very bright colors are used. Here, the same color sequence will be used for the lady also. But now this has all dried, and I'll show you all the details on this and then I will go ahead. So we'll wait for this has dried and I can show you how do we do that. Now this I'm taking a waterproof pen, which is a Uniball eye. You have to check your pen, it has to be waterproof. If in case it is not waterproof, it will bleed. Now once your paint is done, after that you can also use a gel pen because you are very sure that you will not be using water up on it. So if you have a black gel pen, then also you can do it. Now, what is the difference when we have to use a waterproof pen and when a gel pen normal, which is not waterproof? Here, I drew this and later I will be coloring, as in like when I will be using the water on it, it will bleed. It will just blend with the paint. But here, once it is all dried, I can use a waterproof color or brush, this pen or a gel pen. That is totally okay. Now, here, what I am doing is a black outline for this. You will see that all your coloring, whatever little ups and downs you would have made, will go away. That was the main reason I was not very particular about that. Now this can be done in black also, and this can be done in dark green color also. So here I'm just going and doing the outline. There will not be much of the designing in the trunks and all. So whatever pencil lines I made, they are still showing up from beneath. And then you can just draw over it. If in case you do not want to do those lines before and you are confident that okay, later you can do those lines, that can also be done. So depending on your comfort level, I wanted to show you all the details first. How do we do that? And now this is the coloring part where I'm using poster color swatches. So this is a very general scene. In our coming up sessions, we will be talking about very specific and contextual pictures. So contextual pictures will have some relative, some story behind. First, we will talk about how to make the male and the female figures and the sceneries. And then, so Saturdays and Sundays, please keep your time for me at 3 o'clock. And then we can do the artwork together. And in the matter of just 5 or 6 hours that you will give it to me, you will know one traditional folk art completely. And then you can make one of your own kind. So, any questions that you may have, and you can write it to me in the comments as well. If you like the workshop, please hit on to the like so that I get to know. Share this workshop also with others who might get benefited. So there's so much you can do to support the channel. Here I'm just doing the outline. Here. Now when we look at this, the whole picture comes to life when the back, when the border is done. The border is done in red and green and yellow. So that is one thing that is very, very beautiful in the picture. Here, this is the way we will be doing the leaf. Whatever I did it in pencil, I'm doing it in pen quickly to give the whole look, and then we will go on to coloring this beautiful lady. Now, whenever we look at the figures that we draw in Fard, it is always the side posture. Very rarely, or rather, I would say not even one time, you might, if in case some artist takes it up and makes a front figure, that's a different take on it. But ideally, you will see only the side postures in Fard, not the front. So even animals, people, courtrooms, everything is shown in the side view. The animals that are shown here are camel, because it is from Rajasthan, camel, elephants, horses, and all the animals that are in the palace. So this is for the violins. What cloth to use, ma'am? Okay, cloth that you can use is a pure cotton, khadi, or canvas. Now today we are doing a very simple one. Tomorrow we'll just go a little more advanced onto this. The dots can also be used on the clothing of people. Simple flowers and leaves are often seen for design. So these are illustrative paintings, as in it te they tell the story. The reason is, and that is why they are shown in this way, that they are very far. So you will not see any too much of detailing in it, because it is from a bigger perspective. So it's not very close. So you will not see the inside scenes. You will not see the details on the face. So I would like to know, anybody who is right now attending and is from Rajasthan, from where we are talking about this painting, anybody who isn't from Rajasthan, please let me know. Okay, nobody from Rajasthan here right now. Now, what the design we do on these are the small lines that we can do for the detailing. You can use different color pens or paints. Okay, Sarda. Sarda is from Rajasthan. Okay. So here this. Now here what I'm doing in black, you can also do it. Oh, Anushree, okay. Kanganang, so many from Rajasthan. Wow, good. Did you know about this art before? As in like, or is it the first time you're drawing it? Ganganagar, okay. You must have seen such art forms there. So this is all the small part detailing that we have done. We can do all such things. But the more things that we can do is we can just do the small little details. Now, the more thing can be added is a curtain over here. That's pretty much that we do about this. I will show you how to add that as well. So since I said we also use blue color, and I'm taking blue, I'll show you how to do it directly. So when they are done directly. This is the blue curtain. I give it a break over here right now. I'll wait for it to dry, because I will do the yellow border to it. Now you can also likewise, I did this curtain without drawing. You can also do the same. This is how actually these things are done. Now you can add as many details as you want here. If I want to add a musnud here, or the gold takia, or whatever the round pillow, whatever you call it, we can also add that. This is also seen. Okay, so here. So this is basically a lady sitting in the court and looking at the scenery outside. So this is a very small piece of picture that we are doing. Now we'll go quickly and color this part also. The ladies or all the figures, the faces are done in yellow without any shade work. So just fill in the bright yellow color for the face and whatever body part is visible. So here in this case, it is face. the hands and the torso or the body. The hand portion also, without any shade work, no shades involved. This is the neck, and that this is the ear. Now when we do this, we have to also consider that all the jewelry stays yellow. So I'm just taking this part, doing the jewelry part yellow. And doing the border of the sari. I'll wait for it to dry a little before I just do the edging of it. And for the sari, here I forgot to erase the line, pencil line. I can take a bright yellow to do the dress. In Rajasthan, we see that mostly bright color dresses are being worn. They wear very bright dresses. Even then, the embroidery on cloths and all is very bold and bright. So if somebody is working with me, you can also mention if you are working along. Oh, is it? Am I audible now? Yes, you can also, Deepa, you can also draw on an A3 size paper or even bigger, depending on how much big you want to draw. You can also reduce the size to A5 or the half of A4. That is also done. This here, and I will take the red, bright red color for the blouse. You can also take green, whatever your choice is, but there won't be any shading involved in this. Whatever color you choose, you have to take it and fill it flat for the dress. The only thing that you can do later is just add some details in a contrast color. So that is what we can do. Okay, Sarda is drawing and very good. So those who are drawing and would want to draw, please share your pictures on Art Thrill Studio Facebook group. Please join the group where you can just post your pictures as well. I'm taking the bright green color to do the dupatta. And here, this is the place where the hair is, and here I'm doing it with the pen itself. So you have to do the black for hair. I'll wait for it to dry so that I can do the detail part on it. Okay, you can also share it to me on WhatsApp, because most of you are connected to me personally on WhatsApp. You can share it there as well. No issues. So So here I'm taking a blue color for. Now we'll wait for this portion to dry so that we can go ahead and do the pen work over it. The bangles I'll go on red again. Small features of the ones which are left, the sepals of the plant. This the yellow of the jewelry, few portions wherever we are left with, I'm just doing it in yellow. Here, this we'll wait for this to dry, and whichever portion is dried already, like the curtain, we'll do the outline. Again, the tassels that are the curtain, the folds, I'm doing it with pen directly. Small prints on the dress can also be done. This is a sitting posture of a lady, a single lady here, and this is all has to be dried, and then we will do the outline on it. So this is how we do the fud painting. This is a very small picture that we did. Now tomorrow we will be doing little more, showing you the full figure and the distinctive feature of how to make a female figure. And every time we make a female figure, we will put it in a different kind of a setting where you will see a little bit more about the background of how to do it. Anybody has any questions, please you can raise it. So I'm answering all your questions now. I hope you enjoyed doing this with me and knowing a little more about FUD art. We will be sharing informations in every workshop regarding the topics that we take. So, anybody has any questions, I will wait for your questions and then I will answer all of them. Yes, you may join the WhatsApp link that is given over there. So those who are not a part of the WhatsApp group, you can just be the part of the WhatsApp group, and if in case you want, Facebook page is also there, Facebook group is also there. Can you show the border? Okay, sure, I can show you the border. The border is plain flat coloring. Okay, so I'll just extend a little and then I'll show you, because actually a little portion of it I can show you right now. So taking it in a red, I'll just put it down again so that you can see the border. Yes, Deepa, in case you are not able to send it on the group, you can always personally send it to me, because when you send it to the group, this filter on the group is only to avoid unnecessary messaging and troubling others. So you can any time I will be available and you can message me directly on my WhatsApp. So here I am doing this border. I'll just keep this paper beneath so that I can go a little free on coloring it. Yeah, those yes, this you can watch on the YouTube channel. It will be very much available. If you cannot do it right now, you want to complete it. Those who want to take certification in for art course, you can message me directly on my through WhatsApp or my Facebook. So here, this is the border. Just keeping a little a paper for just securing this thing. So here I'll show you one side of how to do it, and then later you can go ahead and do the other portions, all four sides. Okay, if in case you want to use it on the cloth has to be 100% cotton, khadi or canvas. And the paints that you would be using on that will be acrylic paints. Acrylic paints, or if in case you want to use the fabric as a wearable fabric, then go ahead and do it with the fabric paints. Now, there is a difference between fabric paints and acrylic paints also. So, acrylic, if you in case you want to get the painting framed and you want to display it, that is the other scenario. You can take acrylic paint. If in case you are doing it on the cloth and you wanted to wear it and wash it, then you have to go for a this fabric paint. Fabric paint can be washed, the other one may not be. WhatsApp group, the link has been shared on the top, please check. So I have shared the link to join the WhatsApp group. If you're not a part of it, you may join it. Now here I'm just giving it a little for the border. It's green and red. Taking a flat brush, I'm just rolling it and giving it one line. So this is how it will come. It comes really beautiful when the border is done. I thought I was taking a little more time, that's why I didn't do it, but since asked, I'll be more happy to show you. The brightness of the painting increases when you do the border in flat colors. It's meant to be flat colors. It's only very little few line work. You see it in few very big paintings. Other than that, it is all flat coloring. Now, once these two are done, you may leave this pipeline, which we say, which is a very thin line border in white also, or you can color it yellow. I'll show you how to color it in yellow. Once this is all dried up, the way I used to do the thin lines, sorry for the shake here, I'll take the yellow and I'll just very easy and quick way of doing the border and keeping a straight line on the border is take the scale and take the scale which has a little thickness. Now you put it like this so that your brush doesn't stick to the border of the scale. You will have some thickness over here. Align it and then using the brush, just make a line. So this is a very easy way of making the border. Definitely your scale, the ruler will take in some paint. You'll have to wipe it away. So this is how you can go quick on making the borders. When we do bigger paintings, we use this kind of a method to get one fine line of the border. But you have to use the wrong side of the scale. So you just use it up like this, and then you go and make the line. Your line will come very straight and even. So, and with one go, and it's very quick. There are two numbers. Okay. You can contact on any of those two numbers. Okay, so this is the look of how it will come. So this portion you will be able to see that once the border is done, how the look of the picture changes. And yes, you can go ahead and do all the four sides in the border, and this is how it will look. So I hope you enjoyed doing a little bit with me for the first day in Ferd, and I'll see you all tomorrow at 3 o'clock. So here, any questions, you can write it in the comment section. I'll go through it and I'll revert it back to you. And it was fun here to be with you after a long time. So good to see you all. I hope you attend all the session, all the sessions, and know about this beautiful art form. So here, bye bye for today. I'll see you all tomorrow. Thanks for joining in and sharing some time with me. Thank you.